is what I have near me. So these are the movies I love. I don't like a lot of them, so just say. So we got Goosebumps. No idea. Never seen this movie. Don't even know why I have this movie. Wow, look at that. The light is, wait. There we go, the light. We have to keep it on the left side so it doesn't reflect. Yeah, well, there's nothing even to say about that movie because I've never even seen it. Oh, God. Alvin and the Chipmunks. This movie's pretty good. It came out in 2007. I do remember that. And it's probably one of the best cartoon movies out there. It has a really good plot. It's basically where a guy traps everyone in a dome and tries to blow up Springfield. And Homer has to stop. Starts hating on him. Next we got Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, or as the Americans would call it for some weird reason, Sorcerer's Stone. This is also a very good movie. Considering specials. It's definitely up there. Journey to the Center of the Earth. Now these used to have 3D glasses, but they don't anymore because I lost them, so. That makes a good sound. This guy and his kid go to the center of the earth with this woman whom this came out when, like, they started doing 3D movies, and they had, like, one 3D scene at the start of the movie, so it was technically 3D, so they could up the price by, like, £10 or £15 to see it 3D, when we know it wasn't really. Next, we got Happy Freaking Christmas, Family Guy. Once again, another... This one's a little bit... special in Family Guy history, so. Drop Dead Fred. I've never seen it. Don't know why I have it, but. Got nothing even to talk about that. Next. It says Joshua Ashworth at the top, and now my name is Joshua Williams, so obviously. I used this for like a film class in first school. Everyone had to bring in a movie, and I brought in Labyrinth because I'm cool like that. Obviously, didn't get voted to win, I'm pretty sure I only got a couple votes. So, yeah. They recently added this to Netflix in the UK. I'm not sure if it's anywhere else. I think it might be just like a European add to Netflix thing. Obviously, includes the late, great David Bowie. And he wears some interesting... trousers in, well, he wears like leggings in the movie. They are definitely interesting, definitely worth a watch. We got Ace Ventura, Pet Detective. That just sums it up. That just sums the movie up. But yeah. Really funny movie. This is like prime Jim Carrey in the 90s. I think this came out in the, 94. So yeah, prime Jim Carrey in the 90s when he was doing like, Pet Detective, Dumb and Dumber, there was another Ace Ventura, I forget. It's not coming to my head, but this was prime Jim Carrey. The Mask, which I... Wait, have I already showed the mask? No, I've got the mask. Got the mask here. So, I'm a big prime Jim Carrey fan. A lot of people actually don't like The Mask. So, which is surprising to me. I really rate it. I really rate 90s Jim Carrey. despicable me one is. I also went to see Minions in cinemas when that came out. That movie was trash. And now we got the WWE stuff. I have with me. Once again, I have a lot more stuff, and I'm not into WWE like I was anymore. Way not into it anymore as I was. We got WrestleMania 22 and 21. Favorite wrestler wins the world title from Triple H, and then you got WrestleMania 22, and you got Raw, the best of Raw 2009. So yeah, that's all the movies I have near me. I could definitely do a part 2 and a part 3, because I could probably go up to like part 10 with the amount of movies I have. So if you guys want that, definitely tell me. But yeah, hopefully you enjoyed some insight on these random movies I have near me, the most random movies ever. Subscribe and